Lord, who truly make the one that makes the miracles in our life. Join us in worship the Lord.
Blessed evening, brothers and sisters. Welcome to our Bible study for tonight, English Bible study. So it's me, Brother Ron, from Metanoia Christian Ministries, with my brothers here, Pastor Macho.
Hello, good evening, everyone. What a great and good and pleasant Wednesday to all.
Good evening to all of you. Wednesday is here again, and we'd like to welcome you for watching and listening this Metanoia Broadcasting. And bless you all.
Yes, good evening.
So, praise God. Praise God. You know, praise so God. It's been...
I am feeling, Brother Ron, na parang umaatikabo yung topic natin for tonight. Parang nararamdaman ko yung ano, parang the ground is already shaking for whatever it is that you are to teach tonight. Ano ba yan?
Amen. You know, we have a really good, really, really good topic tonight. You know, this is something that is so basic yet is so overlooked by the body of Christ. You know, guys, you know, these past months we've been doing these broadcasts, we've been doing these live Bible studies, we've been doing all these trainings and what online, and we get a lot of questions. And you know what, guys, honestly, I've already come up with templates. You know what I mean? Because it's the same questions from the same people, from different people, but same questions. Like, oh, what about this? What about that? Especially about healing or
did God allow this? Did God allow that?
Yeah. That's the usual. Okay. Guys, if there's anything, I got to say this to everyone. If there's anything about our teaching, what we focus on Jesus. Who Jesus is, what he did in the cross, and who you are now because of Christ. Plain and simple. And here's the thing, that when you hear stuff that we teach and preach, it hurts something in you that you thought was right all these years. Yeah. It's like the preloaded doctrine or... Because that's the thing, when you indoctrinate instead of impart, there's a big difference. If you're indoctrinating like, oh, this, then you read your Bible, you're just creating more, you know. In this ministry, we do not indoctrinate. We live by example. You know, when Jesus ascended into heaven, he said, teach them to observe all these things. Observe. You watch. Teach them to observe what Jesus did you do. John 14:12. The same works that he did, we will do also. Right? Because he's going to the Father, and even greater works than these. So Jesus didn't say, sit in a classroom and take notes and do this and do that. Jesus said, look, observe. And guys, you know, it's not about, I mean, don't get me wrong. It is super important to have solid theology, right doctrine, amen, good discipline, whatever, amen. You know, that's good. I'm not saying that's bad, but if that's all that you're holding on to, you will miss out on the Holy Spirit. And what you will have is a mishmash of dead religion na puro akala. Akala, oh, ganito. Kasi it's preloaded doctrine that you're assuming that everything bad happens automatically is from God. Where'd you get that from? Where is your foundation? So, guys, I just want to make it clear. If you meet us in person, if you see us in person, honestly, sobrang kulit natin eh. You know, it's a Bible study. It's like a...
Not so much. We try to control ourselves.
You know, as much as possible, gusto na ipakita sa tao, you know, na being a Christian is not boring.
No,
okay,
not.
So kung kaya mo magsaya nung hindi ka pa Christian, nung hindi ka pa born again, well, mas masaya kapag Christian ka na at hindi ka dapat nagpipigil because it's already automatic to you to be joyful always in the Lord.
Saka yan, palagi ko sinasabi sa mga under sa akin, enjoy mo yung walk mo.
Yes.
Pag hindi ka enjoy, hindi si God yun.
So pagka may control, pagka lagi kang bawal to, bawal yan, well, walang peace yun.
Ito na lang kasimple. Diba? Ito kasimple. Sino nagsabing ito yung Christian? Who said that? Who set that norm? That you're a Christian, you have to be like this. You have to talk in a certain, clear, and calm manner. Bawal ka na magalit, bawal ka mag-emotion, dapat ganito ka. Sino nagsabi nun?
Hindi lang yun. And even like us, kami ngayon, ganito, nagtuturo kami, dapat kabarong, dapat, di ba?
No. Eh, akin lang, indoctrination yun eh.
Yes.
You know, so my point is, like what Brother Eric said, you're supposed to enjoy your walk with the Lord. He is a good God. You know, He is not a boss that you go to work and kailangan perfect ako. Kung hindi ako perfect, papagalitan ako ni boss. You know, that's not how it works. So anyway, guys, we're not against people. We're not against, you know,
denominations. Hindi namin sinasabi na bawal magbarong.
No.
Sinasabi lang namin, you know, you must enjoy it. Kasi ang God natin, si God, hindi naman siya yung tipo na nasa taas at na may CCTV bawat galaw mo, bawat punta mo, naka-CCTV siya, tapos zoom in pag nagkakasala ka. That is not God.
So, you know, the point lang is, yung relationship with God, the reason why so many people shy away from the relationship with God is that it feels like a job. It feels like an obligation. Guys, we are not against people. We are not against institutions. We're not against denominations. We are against dead religion and bad doctrine. Why? Because it kills people, literally.
Kaya, pag sinasabi ko, kailangan ko magpahinga sa Sir Cookie God, may problema yun. Actually, ang dami ko narinig niyan.
Being with Jesus is already rest.
Yeah. Amen.
Yung sabing, di ba, kailangan ko ng pahinga muna.
Well, that's how they coined the word sabbatical. I want to do a sabbatical. You know, it's time off from... but in fact, that's actually a way out of context because our life should be in relationship with the Lord, and that's 24/7.
You know, we have a teaching on that. If you want to learn more about that rest in Jesus, go search on Metanoia Christian Ministries YouTube page, Lord of Shabbat. That's a good message on Hebrews 4 that you should really hear. Anyway, so, you know, we're blessed to be here. It is a privilege to share the word with all of you. It's a privilege to communicate with you and get the messages and testimonies from you and to see your support and all the stuff that you, like so many of you have reached out and actually even blessed the ministry. So praise God. You know,
thank you so much for you.
We thank the Lord for you. And, you know, we won't be able to do this without you. So it is a blessing. And
indeed, it's a blessing.
Kaya pakumpleto ng pakumpleto yung studio natin.
Yeah. Well, it's true. Well, just things on the side. We just love how the Lord has been blessing this ministry.
If you could just see them right there.
the talents that we have being supplied by the Lord, the equipment that we're having, it's just really a blessing.
Amen.
Outflow of this relationship with the Lord.
You know, and see, it's the Lord who gives the increase. You know, it's just as long as you abide in Him, fruitfulness will come about. And I'm just blessed. I'm blessed by all of you watching. I'm blessed by all of you who pray with us, pray for us, to, you know, support and, you know, just extend blessings. Praise God for you guys. So, anyway, can I ask you, Pastor Macho, to open us in prayer?
All right, let's pray. Almighty Father in heaven, Lord God, we thank you so much for this day. We thank you so much for this night, Lord God, that we are together once again, Lord God, that we are about to study your word, Lord God. Lord, whatever it is that is about that we are about to study tonight, Lord God, may it be open to the hearts of the people that is listening right now. And right now, I rebuke any kind of hindrances of Satan, you evil spirit, you get out right now in the name of Jesus Christ, that every word that will come out of Ron's mouth will be coming from you and you only, Lord God. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So I got a very interesting message tonight, and it's a very simple and basic message, as should be. You know, the gospel does not complicate it. Doesn't have to be complicated. Religion complicates the gospel.
It excites me when you say simple, because I could actually understand it.
So I love this. I love this, and it will step on religious toes. Okay, so guys, again, I'm not against people. I'm not against institutions. I'm against bad doctrine. I'm against dead religion. I'm going to hate evil. The Bible instructs us to hold fast to what is good, but abhor evil. You know, so plain and simple, if something is killing a child of God, if something is keeping a child of God in chains, I don't like that. You know, so if I do get emotional sometimes, you know, that's just the flesh. But I'm not angry at people. I just want to share the word. And you know, again, I have to go back. That's been such a revelation to me. What one of our sisters in the ministry said, that when you hear stuff like doctrine that maligns God or talks,
it hurts.
Yung parang sinisiraan tatay mo.
Masakit nun. Masakit sobra yun.
Diba? Like if you were a parent and then like one of your kids' schoolmates or something would spread bad rumors about you, you know, that would bother you. That would affect your child. So that's where I'm coming from. Because my father, our father in heaven, is good. And only good.
Only good.
And very, very good. So good.
All that he
good.
Created is good. You know, the last Bible study I led with the Iloilo group, man, I praise God. If you guys are watching, I love you guys. So blessed
praise
by
God,
you guys.
Praise God.
Because that they really received the truth of who Jesus was and what Jesus did on the cross. And I really pointed out that God is good. That everything he created was good. In Genesis 1, everything. He created this, it was good. He did this, it was good. He did this, it was good. He created man, it was very good. God did not create anything bad. It was man who sinned and brought all the bad in there. So, yeah, anyway, you know, so connecting this to my message today is entitled Sozo, okay, Sozo. It's spelled S-O-Z-O. So what is Sozo? The sozo, in the New Testament, as you guys may know already, the New Testament is originally written in Greek. Okay, the Greek language, sozo. So sozo means saved. Okay, sozo means saved. So when you are saved, you are sozo, right? When you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, you are sozo. You receive sozo. So sozo is a very powerful word. It's very important. It is the core of Christianity. It is the core of New Testament Christianity. That is exactly the heartbeat of the whole thing, that Jesus came and we now have sozo because of Jesus Christ. So, but here's the thing. You know, Greek and English don't literally translate automatically. So there are, I think, any two languages naman. There's not really a direct correlation. Like in Tagalog, we have so many words that you can't really explain in English, like directly one word for one word.
Wala kasi talagang direct translation eh. Somehow parang, what are the examples ba?
Tampo.
Tampo is...
There's no direct English for tampo.
You can describe it.
But you could describe
it's
it.
It's just like a direct word. Or, diba? You know what I mean? So there's...
Parang
there's
sa love, diba? In love kasi, iba-iba yan.
Iba-iba. Like in Greek, the word love, there's like six different kinds of love. Or five, diba? So, and there's a bunch of other words in Greek that doesn't have a direct translation to English. So whatever the Bible translator did, kaya nga, guys, yung translation ng Bible, whatever you're reading, it's not perfect. Yeah. The Bible is perfect in its form, but there's no perfect translation. Yeah. So it is our duty to really go and seek, you know, go invest in a concordance, go invest in, like when we teach, we use what, four or five different translations, just to make sure that we have a proper understanding of the original text, you know, and I will show you today why it's so important to go deep, dig deeper, and understand. Hindi yung okay, ito sabi sa akin, okay na. You know, so let's go to Luke 7. I'm not gonna read the whole thing, you know, I'm not gonna read the whole thing in Luke 7, 44 to 50, but just a little background on this situation. There was a Pharisee, again, during that time, Jesus was a rock star, man. Like, you know, everybody, he was.
He's rock the ultimate star. Rock star.
He was, baga parang sa time natin yan, parang K-pop yan, BTS.
Yung following.
BTS or Blackpink.
Yung following yan.
Yung followers naman talagang pagka dumating, talagang nagsisigaman.
Kasi pare, who could heal the sick?
That's right.
Who could raise the dead? Not even doctors could do anything like that. But here's a man who grew up in that, some random town.
That's right.
Carpenter. Ano to? And all of a sudden, he could heal the sick, blind eyes open, the lame walk, deaf, diba?
Yes. So I could just imagine, like Jesus Christ, before coming into town, all the people is just waiting for him.
That's right.
Like they bring out all the sick people, they lay them out on the road. When Jesus Christ came, he was giving high five to everybody. While giving high five, they get
they
healed.
Healed.
Like, and then everybody that touches him just get healed. And what a rock star he is, you know? Yeah. In this modern day, I've always viewed Jesus us like that.
So who got offended by Jesus?
Siyempre, yung mga religious spirit.
Exactly. So
it's always the part to see, you know, and the sad to see.
Kaya sad to see.
You know, it's funny that Hebrews 13:8 says Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever. Unfortunately, the Pharisees are also the same yesterday, today, and forever. You know, so
yung lahat yun dahil may doctrine silang.
Yeah. Bit kasi nila, bit na bit nila.
So, hindi, yung nga, hindi doctrine. It's really a relationship.
Yeah. Oh, important yung tamang doctrine. Okay yung doctrine eh. But if you don't have, even if with the right doctrine, but the wrong relationship
wala.
You will explode. You know, you will explode and that's not gonna...
So, yung nga, yung doctrine mo should come from
relationship. Amen.
Hindi yung relationship mo dahil ito doctrine mo.
Mm. Amen, ganda. That was good, that's very good. You know, so anyway, so here's in Luke 7, there's a story about a Pharisee inviting Jesus. I'm not going to read through the whole thing because sayang, this is limited yung time natin. Anyway, so a Pharisee invited Jesus over to eat, and then he went in, and then a woman came with an alabaster jar and poured it on him, and she was crying. And then the Pharisee was saying, if you knew who this woman was, you wouldn't let her touch you. You know, if you knew who this woman is or what she has done, so in other words, his intention for inviting Jesus was not to learn, You know, it wasn't for anything. Anyway, you know, so we all know how this goes. Then he talks to Peter and diba, like who has been forgiven much. So anyway, let's go to Luke 7, verse 44. I just wanna read through this. Okay. All right. So Luke 7, verse 44, it says, "Turning toward the woman, he said to Simon, 'Do you see this woman? I entered your house. You gave me no water for my feet, but she has wet my feet with her tears and wiped them with her hair.' Verse 45, 'You gave me no kiss, but she, since the time I came in, has not ceased to kiss my feet. You did not anoint my head with oil, but she anointed my feet with perfume.'" Yung alabaster, that's very expensive. Yeah. Extremely expensive. You know, so verse 47, "For this reason I say to you, her sins, which are many, have been forgiven. For she loved much, but he who is forgiven little loves little. Then he said to her, 'Your sins have been forgiven.' Those who were reclining at the table with him began to say to themselves, 'Who is this man who even forgives sins?' And he said to the woman, 'Your faith has saved you. Go in peace.'" So, I mean, I could teach an hour on this story alone, you know, or more, maybe a series, because this is a beautiful story. But this last line in verse 50, you know, I'm not going to go through the nitty-gritties. My point is just, this is the original understanding of sozo, okay? As the churches teach today, as most of the denominations understand and teach and preach today, this is sozo. It's spelled S-O-Z-O, but for some reason in Greek, you parang may D, eh. Sozo, eh. Diba? So anyway, so my point lang is, this is the original understanding. When you say sozo or saved, ito yun. Your sins are forgiven. Jesus has you come to Jesus, you repent, and then you make him your Lord and Savior, and then you are saved. Ito yun. Ito yung, I'd say 95% of Christianity would say that this is automatically, this is what their understanding of the word sozo is. You know, and that agrees with John 3:16. And John 3:16 is such a basic verse that everybody knows about it. John 3:16 and 17, let me read. It says, this is NASB, by the way. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send the Son into the world to judge the world." Ito, napakalino nito. "But that the world might be sozo through him." Saved through him. So in Luke 7 and in John 3:16, the word saved. Your faith has saved you. Diba? Yun yung point eh. Luke 7:50, "Your faith has saved you. Go in peace." Yung John 3:17, it says that the world might be saved through him. So saved is the world, is the word sozo. So plain and simple, if you believe in Jesus, you are sozo. Amen? So if you're watching this right now and you believe in Jesus, because I don't think you'll watch this video if you don't believe in Jesus. Unless you're really bored and you have nothing to do. I don't know. But I mean, that's good. If you're watching and you're not a believer, maybe this will wake you up.
It's right? Still a great choice if you're watching this one and you're bored. Good job.
That's good. That's good. That's good. You know, that you may hear the truth. And amen. I'll take that. You know, I'll take that. But anyway, so your faith has sozo you. Jesus came into the world to sozo you. So are we saved?
Yes.
Are you saved?
Very well.
Diba? It's an uncomfortable question. It's a joke. It's a joke. But diba?
Are we safe?
Patay. Patay.
Actually, meron nagtatanong niyan. Paano mo maging sure na safe ka?
Parang...
Meron.
Anong gospel?
Kasi normally pagpunta ka church kasi, dapat gawin mo to. Dapat
works,
so hindi mo
works.
Nang gagawa, nagda-doubt ka kung safe ka talaga o hindi. Yeah.
So,
hindi nila naintindihan bakit sila safe.
I like that because that's my next verse.
Okay, sorry.
No. That's good. That's good.
That's just a leading question.
Yeah. That's good. No. Okay, so we all know this. It's Ephesians 2, 8 and 9. Because tama yung sabi ni Brother Eric, there's so many people that think salvation is by works. It's not. You cannot earn sozo. It's given freely by grace, right? So Ephesians 2, verses 8 to 9, NASB. It says, for by grace, meaning it's a free gift, unmerited favor. Guys, you know this. Basic na to. Pag ito hindi pa tinuro ng church, di na church yun. Okay? For by grace, you have been saved through faith. Because God has given sozo by grace, you have to take it by faith. Hindi pwedeng, oh, by grace, okay na lahat. You have to receive it. There's no receiving mechanism. So it's not a giving problem. It is a receiving problem. So it says, for by grace you have been saved through faith, that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not as a result of works, so that no one may boast. Yung saved dyan, sozo. So John 3:16, sozo. Luke 7:50, sozo. Ephesians 2:8, you have been sozo through by grace through faith. So that's what sozo means. Okay? It's such an important word, guys. It's
ganda,
such...
Ganda ng sozo. Isipin mo, meaning din yan is to keep safe and sound.
Mm.
Talagang rescue from danger.
Amen. Yan ang, ano so, din... so lahat tayo, agree tayo, as Christians, I know, if you believe in Jesus, obviously you can say right now, I am sozo. Say it. You say it. You declare it. I am sozo.
I am sozo.
Amen. So... plain and simple, because of Jesus, because of grace, not because of works. So, most Christians will agree that we are saved by grace, we are sozo by grace, and we agree that we are all sozo. So here's my question. How come people don't want the other definitions of sozo? I'm going to read the definition of sozo for you right now. And it's probably up on the screen. May ano naman siya, diba? Anyway, so sozo. From a primary word, okay, it's contraction, to save, that is to deliver, to protect, to heal, to preserve, to save, to do well, to be made whole.
Wow, made whole.
Made whole. Hindi
how
made
do you define whole?
Buo.
Buo.
Kumpleto. Kumpleto.
Ano yan eh? Spiritually tsaka physical.
Yes.
Kasi madami is puro spiritual lang yung nabuo.
Ano yan yung ano natin?
Pero pati physical, pati body, anything.
Everything. So now, okay. So just prior to this, we all agree that we are sozo. Okay? But this is what the word means. Why is it that so many modern day teachings of Christianity has removed all these other definitions and just moved it for saved?
Eternal life.
But what happened to the other definition? What happened to deliver, to protect, to heal? Especially to heal. People hate healing.
Wow.
I don't understand that. That's one of the things that we get most persecuted for is healing.
Eh, kasi inalaw ni God yung healing, kaya huwag mo pakilaman. O yung sickness, kaya huwag mo pakilaman.
Eh, kasama siya sa saved eh. Kasama siya dito. It's the same word. So for you to say, I am saved but not healed, does not make sense.
Yeah.
It's like saying, gusto ko ng tubig pero di basa.
Eh, tsaka, ang ano nila is, gusto lang ni God, punta tayo heaven, pero dito,
mag-suffer ka.
Oh, sayang
maghirap
man.
Ka. Oh, wow.
Bahala ka sa buhay mo muna dito.
So this is painful to see. You know why? Because you are already sozo. Guys, just plain and simple, right here, right now, you already have this. You just said it a few minutes ago, I am sozo. If I am sozo, then I am saved, I am protected, I am delivered, I am healed, I am preserved, I am doing well, I am made whole. I am whole. I am. Because of Jesus Christ, I am healed, I am saved, I am whole, I am protected, I am doing well, I am... This is it. So, why... Sakit sa bangs eh. Alam mo yun?
Sa totoo lang.
No. Pero, you know, it hurts. You know why? Because this is the problem, guys. This is why we get a little emotional sometimes. Is that we see people that need this. We see Christians who are depressed. We see Christians who are suicidal. We see Christians who are demonized. We see Christians who are sick or broken. And then they say, I need help. But the word itself here means that when you receive Jesus, you already have this.
Yeah.
Amen? So this is what I want to go at. Okay, if people question the definition of the word, oh, baka naman strong lang yan or whatever. Okay, let's go to the text, let's go to the scripture and run through... run through the applications of sozo in the Bible. Let's go to Luke 8, verse 12. Okay? Luke 8, verse 12. We should not be watering down the definition of the word sozo. Okay? So, Luke 8, verse 12. It says, those beside the road are those who have heard. Then the devil comes and takes away the word from their heart, so that they will not believe and be saved. Yung saved dyan, sozo na naman yan. Okay? So again, I'm going to read this again. Those beside the road are those who have heard. Then the devil comes and takes away the word from their heart so that they will not believe and be saved. So what does Satan want to prevent? Satan wants to prevent sozo. Plain and simple.
Ang sakit naman pag sinasabi mo yung mga ayaw maniwala na ano ng demonyo.
How else do you want to define that?
Totoo yan.
Hindi nakasulat sa Bible.
Ano talaga kayo?
Oh. Ang mas masakit dyan, yan ang tinuturo ng ibang simbahan.
Okay.
Yung save, pare, they don't so really deliver it as a whole. Save,
mas nakikinikila kay Satan kaysa kay God.
Wow. Choice yan eh. You know, but that's what happens when you go doctrine first before relationship. So now, what people are passing on is a sozo that has been watered down. It's been sozo that, oh, you're forgiven, saved, but that's it. No healing, no protection, no deliverance, nothing. Just saved and forgiven. Who gave you the authority to change the text of the Bible or the meaning of the word?
Experience.
Well, then that's you will answer to God for that, you know? And this is really, this is unfortunate because the devil comes and takes away the word from their heart so that you will not be sozo. Doesn't that make sense? So why are people sick? Oh, healing, hindi kasi ano yan eh. Kasi ito spiritual lang to, hindi ano yan eh. Deliverance, ay naku, hindi ano yan. Hindi, pare pang ano yan, tapos na yan eh. Spiritual gifts, ay hindi, tapos na yan si Satan.
Eh, mas malalim ako kasi nagtitiis ako.
Oh yeah, kasi sobrang lalim mo, kinuha na ni Satan yung sozo.
Kayo wala kayo sakit, di nyo naiintindihan yung lalim ko.
Oo nga.
Wow!
So, diba may beauty dyan sa ganyan? There's a beauty in brokenness. Anyways.
Darating tayo dyan. So again. If your eyebrows are being raised right now or your blood pressure or your heart is medyo palpitating because of the stuff I'm saying.
Baka naman naihagis yun yung iPad nyo kapahapa pinanon.
Minumura nyo yung si Brother Ron.
Baka nagagalit na kayo sa akin. No, guys, anong point ko? Hindi kami galit. What's my point? Guys, you just said it a while ago. I am sozo. Pag sa forgiven, sa saved, okay ka. Pero pag sa healing, question mark. So, sino yung nag-snatch ng word? It says clearly, Luke 8:12, Satan is the one who snatches it away to prevent you from receiving sozo.
Wow.
So, gawin niya, sige, sobrang dali eh. Diba guys? Sobrang dali. It's so easy to be saved. Believe in Jesus. You don't have to climb a mountain. You don't have to cut your leg off. You don't have to memorize the Bible. You just believe. So Satan cannot prevent something that's that easy. So what is his tactic? He will water down the definition. Sige, I will water it down.
Bawasan niya.
Para sa heaven, ka na lang okay.
Hanggang dito ka lang.
Dito, stop ball ka.
Diba? Pero pag dito sa earth, agad buhay ka, stop ball ka muna.
So it is so difficult to prevent something that is so easy to access and so easy to receive. So what Satan will do is deceive you and disarm the believer so that they don't get any other benefits of being sozo. Diba? So, you know, he will prevent healing. He will prevent you from being made whole. He will convince you that being broken is good even though Christ was broken so you could be whole. So essentially, when you keep on saying, "Oh, broken," you say, "I'm beautifully broken." No, you're spitting on the cross. You're spitting on the cross.
Tsaka ano yun eh? Na-broken na si Jesus para hindi
for
na tayo dadalo.
Ang sakit nun eh. Kaya nga every time na nakakita tayo ng ganyan, nababalitaan natin, we see people na nandyan sa ganyang sitwasyon, it really hurts so much, lalo sa mga puso namin. Kasi alam naman natin what happened to Jesus Christ on the cross and wag naman nating yurakan, kumbaga sa Tagalog.
You see yung passion of the Christ.
Diba? Yun lang nakita nyo na yun, pero ano pa yun eh? Well, watered down din yun.
Toned down version.
Pag grinabi pa yun, maging X-rated na yun.
Oo, oh, grabe.
Pero, I mean, if that alone would bring people to tears, Diba?
What more?
What more the actual thing? And then you will say na, hindi Jesus, ito lang yung gusto ko, ito. Hindi.
Yun nga lang sa buffet na lagi may example, yun nga lang sa pagkain eh, parang ang hirap-hirap ng tanggapin. Yun pang pinahirapan yung mismong Panginoon
gusto
natin.
Gusto mo lugaw lang.
Tapos gusto mo, kain. Hindi lang, hindi nga lugaw, yung suka lang ang gusto mo.
Sausawan.
Sausawan lang, di ba? Hindi mo malang, kahit man lang sana kinain ang ginawa mo, hiyawakan mo yung tokwa, sinausaw mo, tinilaan mo lang.
Eh, kasi pag kumain ng maasim, nabro-broken siya eh.
Diba? Sobra ka naman. Suka nalang, tinilaan pa. Pakainin mo naman ng konti.
Kasi nga ganun ang gusto niya mangyari. O, makakaya naman eh.
Hindi man lang tinapay diba? Eh.
Pero eh, alam nyo ba yung kinain mo? May kakain ba mang iba nun?
But there's actually a lot of truth in that metaphor. Na yung salvation kasi niyan, it's all being paid for. Like whatever yung sinasabi ni Brother Ron, yung so-so na yan, once you get the full grasp of that, that should make you a victorious Christian.
Amen.
And I don't want to preempt it. Tignan natin kung anong doktrina yung pinanghahawakan natin. Bakit ayaw natin ng zotso?
So, anyway, guys, bottom line, wala kaming masamang intention dito. What we want you to be victorious.
Yes. Amen.
Because you know what? You know, if there's something fighting in your heart right now, saying, ito naman, sobrang ganito, ganyan. You know what? Evaluate your traditions. Evaluate your doctrine. Evaluate your theology. Because there's not supposed to be any. You're supposed to be saying amen. You're not supposed to be saying no. Eh, may sickness ako. You're not supposed to be justifying your defeat. Yes. You're supposed to be thinking, why am I defeated now that Jesus has paid for all this? Whew. Think about that. Bakit? Diba? Yan yun eh. That, after ministering to so many people and hearing hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of questions and reading all that, the justification is it's always justification. O bakit ako may sakit? Bakit ito namatay? Bakit ito? Why do you always look for the negative? It is the human flesh that will direct you to look for the wrong and justify why you are defeated instead of saying, how do I elevate myself? How do I stand up?
How do I fix this?
Yes. So instead of looking for an answer, they want to justify the problem. Brothers and sisters, you already have the answer. You have the answer, and the answer is sozo. And you already have it. Let's go, Luke 8 pa rin, but let's go down. Luke 8, verses 35 to 36. Okay. Luke 8, 35 to 36. Luke 8, NASB, it says, the people went out to see what had happened, and they came to Jesus, and he found the man whom the demons had gone out, sitting down at the feet of Jesus, clothed and in his right mind, and they became frightened. Ito yung demonyak eh. Yes. Si Legion, di ba? So I'm not gonna read through the whole story, but ito lang. So they saw the guy who had the legion of demons in him, and he was sane. Eh, di baliw na to eh, di ba? Yeah. They chained him, he was in the cemetery.
Nakaposas na to eh, naka-chains na si pati paa niya.
Oh, and he would break it.
Malakas to.
Malakas, yeah.
Malakas siya. Legion. Legion of demons, yung punta sa pig. Ito yun eh. So, and then verse 36, okay, verse 36, those who had seen it reported to them how the man who was demon-possessed had been made well. Alam mo yung made well na yan?
Sozo.
Sozo. Because of Jesus.
Gavin.
This man was not just delivered, he was not just made well, he was sozo. So how do you extract, it's the same word as John 3:16, it's the same word as Ephesians 2:8, that you are sozo by grace through faith. And then it's the same word here that this man was delivered from thousands of demons, that nobody could fix him, nobody could help him. Jesus had made him well. And that word is sozo.
Bakit so, kaya ganun, no? Every time na ganyan na Jesus had made someone well, and hanggang ngayon, ganun na rin, yung mga tao dito, pinaalis na si Jesus eh.
Oo nga.
Diba? Diba? Para pag nakakakita siya ng taong gumagaling, doon ka na, wag na dito.
Ay, papaya sila eh. Sila
nakakita sila ng tao na nagwawala, na wala sa sarili, gumaling, tapos please lang, wag ka na rito.
Guguloy mo yung doktrina namin.
Oo nga, we're not ready for that. We're not ready for that.
Grabing revelation yun, ano? Pinalalayo ba kung sino yung nag-save sa'yo?
But that's heartbreaking. You know why? Because I've actually heard people tell me that. Bro, I love what you're doing. Bro, I love your ministry. Praise God. There's so much fruit. But we're not ready for that.
Oh, yun yung we're not ready.
A lot of people are saying that.
Dami ko rin narinig yun.
That's heartbreaking.
So, yung akin lang, guys, it's not that you're ready or not. It's not, when are you ever gonna be ready? You know, but my point is, you can't extract You can't divide definitions of the same word. So you see, ito nga, yung application niya, freedom from demon, not just demons, para legion to. You know, and you will see in, we don't have to go there, but in Ephesians 6:12, you see there are different hierarchy, there are different level of demons, you have principalities and spiritual forces and this and that. They work as a system. And legion is not as hindi ano yan pipitugin na demonyo yan pare.
Sa Roman Empire, ang legion niya dapat 3,000. Ah.
So I mean if you're well versed in deliverance, alam mong may pinuno yan.
Yeah.
Tas hindi lang yung demonyo diyan, iba-iba yung function yan. So they work together to ano. So anyway, my point is you cannot remove deliverance from sozo. Because that's exactly what it is. Right? So anyway, so move forward. Okay, Luke 8. Baba naman ulit, 48-50. Okay? So ito naman yung ano, yung kay Jairus, di ba? Jairus would come and he would say, "Lord, help my daughter, she's dying," di ba? And then the woman with the issue of blood, yung tinuro ko last time, the woman with the issue of blood who touched Jesus and then she got healed as she touched Jesus. And if you haven't watched that, you got to watch that message. But anyway, so let's go to Luke 8 verses 48-50. Okay? Says verse 48, and he said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you sozo." Sozo. Go in peace. While he was still speaking, someone came from the house of the synagogue official saying, "Your daughter has died. Do not trouble the teacher anymore." But when Jesus said this, he answered him, "Do not be afraid any longer. Only believe and she will be made sozo." Teka lang. Teka lang, isipin natin mabuti yan. So, yung woman with the issue of blood for 12 years that she could not get healed, she suffered many things from the doctor, she spent all her money, she was risking life and death, being stoned to death to touch all those people in the crowd. And when she touched him, what did she receive? Sozo. So, she was healed.
Yes.
Diba? So, nawala yung issue of blood, but she wasn't only just healed, she was sozo. And then, when the daughter of Jairus died, Jesus said, "Do not be afraid any longer, only believe and she will be made sozo." So in this context, healing the woman of the issue with the issue of blood is sozo. Resurrection of the dead is also sozo. My goodness. It's the same word. Brother, sister, you said a while ago, "I am sozo by grace through faith. I believe in Jesus, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but has eternal life," because Jesus was sent to sozo. So you're not just forgiven like the sinful woman in the Pharisee's house. You also have, when you have Jesus, when you have sozo, you also have the power of deliverance. You are delivered. You are healed. This is raising the dead is sozo. It's the same word. Go to Luke 18 verse 42. Okay, Luke 18, verse 42. Pache-pache lang to. I don't want to read through all the stories. It'll take up a lot of time. But Luke 18, verse 42. This is about the blind man, right? And it said, "Jesus said to him, 'Receive your sight. Your faith has made you
sozo.'"
Restoring the sight of the blind is sozo. Pare, meron ka na nito eh. You already have this. You're already sozo. What are you doing begging God to do something that he already did for you through Jesus Christ? This is the same word. Why is no one teaching this? You know, it bothers me because I see people, they come to me, they say, "Brother Ron, can you pray for me? This is what's happening in my life. This is ganyan. I know Jesus, but," laging may but. There's always a but. "But, I don't know what's going to happen." I'm like, do you know what Jesus did on the cross? So sabi ko, let's go back to the cross. Notice, if I've ministered to you, you know I'm going to say, what did Jesus do on the cross? Balik tayo kay Jesus. You know, if sometimes I will cut them short kasi they'll go on for like an hour. No? Kasi ganito, then yung husband ko, then yung ganito. Then
memorize yung, nila yung palpak ng buhay nila pero yung ginawa ni Christ,
hindi
nila alam.
So sabi ko, stop. Kasi kahit, it's not that I don't care. It's like, I don't mind, but you already know your problem and God already knows your problem. I don't have to know your problem. I just have to point you to the answer. And the answer is already here. You have sozo through Jesus Christ. Right? So restoration of the sight of the blind in our last verse, that's sozo. Blind eyes open because of sozo. So Let's go to Luke 9, verse 56. Very important verse. Ito, kung pwede mo i-print to, ipako sa pintuan.
Or, dikit mo sa salamin.
Dikit mo sa salamin or dito.
Or every verse ito, ilagay mo sa post-it, bakit saka pumunta.
Or, yeah. I wanna, you know, I love this verse, and I wanna make a t-shirt of this verse, bro. Because I'm so tired of people saying, oh, God did this to me. God sent COVID. God allowed the cancer. God allowed this and that. I'm so tired of that. You know why? Because if you say that, guess what? You're probably not in a very good position right now. You're saying that to justify why things are broken and it's okay to be broken. But you're not supposed to be broken anymore because you're supposed to be whole. Okay? So I don't say that as an insult. I'm just saying, wake up. It says here, Luke 9, verse 56, for the Son of Man did not come to destroy men's lives. Ano yung cancer, bro? Nakakatulong ba yun o nakaka-ano?
Sakit nun.
Eh, yung poverty, bro. O, okay ba yun?
Ewan ko sa inyo, pero sa akin ayoko yun.
Para ikaw, pag bulag, okay ba yun? Nakakatulong ba yun? No?
Kailangan mo broken. Kung hindi ka magagamit ni God, kung hindi ka na broken.
O di sana lahat ng bulag gamit ni Jesus.
Grabe, di ba?
Sana lahat ng...
Kasi pag sinabi mong kailangan broken ka bago ka gamitin, di parang sinabi mo, magkasala ka muna bago kita gamitin.
Yun nga yung point. Guys, hindi namin sinasabing, kung sitwasyon mo yun, hindi namin sinasabing masama. Okay?
Pero, may sagot.
May sagot eh. Yung point ko, hindi masama, pag bulag ka, it's unfortunate. If you are in a position of poverty right now, that's unfortunate. These are bad things. Ang pinopoint out lang namin, ayaw ni God yun.
So if you are there right now, ito yung sagot.
Ito yung sagot. Hey, hindi mo kailangan dumaan dyan to be used by God. Kasi kung ganun yung case, o di sana nga lahat ng cancer patient naging evangelist. Di ba? Sana lahat ng under poverty, holy man. Hindi naman eh. Diba?
Hindi na kailangan ng Bible school. Punta lang sa hospital.
Magpakahirap ka na lang.
Doon na lang maghanap sa hospital.
Oo. Diba? So, it doesn't apply eh. So guys, I'm not saying it's a sin to be sick. I'm not saying it's a sin to be under poverty. That's not the point. My point lang is, don't blame God. Jesus is God. And He's the same. He's not schizophrenic. Diba? Hebrews 1.3. Wala sa notes. Pero Hebrews 1.3 says that Jesus is the exact representation of the Father. Amen. Sabi niya sa John, diba? I and the Father are one. It says here, the Son of Man did not come to destroy men's lives. Okay? But to sozo. So pwede ba linawin natin kung sino ba talaga God natin? Si Jesus ang God natin, di ba? Oh, so He came para mag-sozo, hindi para sirain tayo. Hindi para baliin yung paa mo para di ka makulit. He came to make you whole.
Nga, rescuing you from destruction. Yan yung meaning niyan. So ano pa bang ibig? Mahirap pa bang unawain yun? Parang andali na. You don't have to be a theologian. You don't have to be a scholar to understand that. Napaka-simple. Plain and simple.
So sa Luke 17, I have a separate teaching on this. I know yan. I yung title ng teaching na yun, Lawless. Very good teaching. Please look it up on the YouTube channel or sa website. Yeah. Sa metanoia.com.ph. Anyway, yung teaching ko na yun was on Luke 17. Ito yung 10 lepers. Okay, so hindi ko na, ano yun, short version na lang to. So, when they said, when they went to Jesus, they asked for mercy, di ba? Sabi ni Jesus, go and show yourself to the priest. Walang prayer, walang lay hands, walang anointing, walang lublub ka muna, just go and show yourself to the priest. And as they went, they were healed, di ba? Gumaling sila. So, all 10 lepers, and by the way, kung di nyo alam, yung leprosy nung time na yun, walang gamot. It's a death sentence. If you had leprosy back then, that was it. You would stay outside the walls until you died and kasi nakakahawa. Walang
lalapit sa'yo.
Wala. And yun lang, hindi lang physical separation. Ang hirap nun kasi you won't see your family anymore.
Isolated ka rin eh. Talagang grabe, emotional.
Exiled. Diba? So, emotional, spiritual. Like in this case, they can't go to the temple. They can't offer for sins anymore. They can't, wala na. It's a game over for you if you had leprosy. Diba?
It's like for them, waiting for them to die.
Yeah.
Tapos, which is very hard.
Aside from the physical and emotional, para spiritually, wala nang pwedeng mag-temple sa kanila. Wala na silang offering. Old Testament to, diba? Law. So they failed the law. So ano yun? Double.
Wala na.
Diba?
sama nun, talagang.
So Jesus saw this, and you know what? He has compassion. We have a compassionate God who loves us. And if my teaching on this, yung lawless, you would check, if you would check the original language of it, you will see multiple definitions of healing. Kasi again, like sozo, walang direct translation eh. So sa English Bible, it may say healed, but there are different words underneath that in the original language. So this is not just in the passage, but I put together some. In Luke 17, the word cured is katharizo. Okay, another Greek word, which means cured, to cleanse. There's another word for healing called iaomai. Iaomai is also healing, to be made whole. Na ano? There's another word, therapueo. So therapueo is like, parang therapy.
Medicine. Yeah.
Diba? Therapy, which also means healed. Meron pa isa, yama. Yama also means healed. So andaming healed, diba? So these 10 lepers, as they went, they received katharizo. Okay, they received katharizo. All of them had went to the priest. They had checked the ano. But the one leper who came back was the only one who received sozo. You know that? Everyone was healed. Only one received sozo. There is a difference. There is a difference. He was not only made well. He was not only cleansed of his leprosy. He was saved. You cannot extract the meaning of these words just for whatever. You cannot just say, I am saved and forgiven, but everything else I toss out the window. You can't. It's the same. Sozo is what raises the dead. Sozo is what brings, allows blind eyes to be opened. It brings hearing to the deaf. It makes the lame walk. It casts out the demons, even a legion of demons. It raises, it's everything. It takes away leprosy. It brings people to heaven. So this is what Jesus accomplished through the word sozo. Sozo is healed, whole, made well, forgiven, resurrected,
delivered,
protected. It's all that. You know, so the mission of Jesus, diba nakita natin yan na ano, yung sa Luke 9:56. He did not come to destroy, but to sozo. So the mission of Jesus is to bring sozo. So why would people want to remove the other definitions of the word? Diba? So guys, you know, I don't mean to offend anyone. Okay? I don't mean to offend you. If you're offended, it's this is the truth. The truth hurts sometimes. This is the Bible. We have not mentioned anything here that is outside these verses. We're not quoting theologians. We're not quoting preachers or pastors. We're not quoting.
This is not even commentary. Ito, nasa word talaga.
We're in the Bible.
It's in the word talaga.
So, this is gonna hurt a little bit. Because nasanay dito yung mga Christian. Eh. But when you claim, I am broken, or I am, God is breaking me, or whatever, or God is doing this, or God is giving me sickness, you are saying that Christ's work on the cross is incomplete.
Parang sinabi mong kulang at walang kwenta.
You call Jesus a liar. You call Jesus a liar because he said he came to sozo the world, but you're like, no, I'm still broken.
Eh, kulang pa, kailangan ko dagdagan.
Kailangan special siya.
So, ano to, the Bible's wrong?
Hindi siya counted sa ginawa ni Christ. Iba siya.
So if you say God is breaking me, you're saying that he's doing the exact opposite of what he sent Jesus to do. Because he sent Jesus to die for you to be whole. He sent Jesus to be crushed and broken and beat up so you could be whole. But you're like, hindi. Gusto ko to eh. Kulang pa yan eh. Gusto ko ng sarili kong cross. Ganun ba yan? Hindi. Totoo lang, guys. You know, I it hurts. What is the addiction to brokenness in suffering? So I'm not saying, guys, na walang suffering sa mundo na to, kasi meron talaga.
Yes, there is. We live in a fallen world. Pero tandaan natin yan. If you are in a situation right now that you are broken, it is not of God's doing.
Yeah. Tama.
Diba? Yun ang tanong dyan, yung kanina sa Luke 8, yung sinabi mo, bakit sino nagpe-prevent niya na maniwala ka?
Satan.
Who? Satan, diba? So did you allow it? Did God allow it? Or did you allow it?
Amen.
Saka na, pag andong ka, it's... Hindi na importante si bakit ka may sakit o bakit may problema ka. Yeah. Ang ino-offer dito, may sagot si God. Di ba? Kasi madami mas focus sila bakit sila meron nun. Di ba? Ang offer ni God may sagot eh. Which yung lahat ng verses ng yung Zozo.
Guys, sobrang simple. You know, again, it hurts to hear Christians say, you know what I mean? Na parang namamatay na ako sa uhaw. May tubig ka naman dyan sa harap mo eh. Grabe, may maawa lang sana sa akin, bigyan ako ng tubig. Brad, ayan no. Di ba? Parang, di mo, ayan sa harap mo. Oh, alam ko na yan, pero... Di ba? Guys, you're begging for something that has already been given. And this is what, ito yung point namin. We want you to experience this. If you are sick, or you are broken right now, you are going through something really bad, someone in your family passed away, you have a relationship that you need restored, guys, ito yung pinakamagandang pwede mong marinig. Yung sagot, you already have the answer. You already have the provision. You know, if you can say right now that I am saved. Now don't just say I am saved. I want you to sit and think right now. Ask yourself, am I really sozo? Do I really believe that I am sozo? Not just saved. Let's go to the original word. Am I really sozo? Because if you meditate that and you realize that, my goodness, if I have faith to believe that I am saved, I have the same faith to believe that I am healed. The faith I need to be saved, to receive Jesus as my, to believe that I am forgiven, is the same faith I need to be delivered. The same faith I have to be protected, to be prosperous, to be made whole. Guys, hindi mo kailangan ng supernatural faith. Kung ano yung faith mo ngayon, that's the same faith. Kailangan mo lang ma-activate. So, you know, guys, let's stop with the yung broken, breaking, suffering.
Testing.
It's anti-sozo.
We minister ako sa jail, di ba? Sa kulungan. Halos lahat ng tao dyan, halos lahat ng nakakulong dyan, palagi nilang sinasabi, hindi, tinuturuan ako ni God ng leksyon, tinuturuan. Kaya I always make it a point na maintindihan nila at maunawaan nila na hindi si God ang nagdala sa iyo dito.
Ikaw yun.
Sino bang gumawa? Sino bang nagnakaw? Sino bang, di ba? Ba't kaya ka nandito? Kasi sa kagagawan mo. But whatever the enemy meant for evil, God can turn it for good.
Amen.
Dito. Aayusin niya, babaliktarin niya. Kasi isipin mo, kung ang Panginoon mo pala ay yung Panginoon na nanenesting, paano ka lalapit sa Panginoon na lagi nanenesting? Hindi, nagkukuha niyo ako, testingin lang ako dyan, dito na lang ako. Imbis na lumapit, napalayo pa.
Hindi, yan nga eh. So, here's the thing. Might as well say that God is making you sin. Or God is making you unsaved to teach you a lesson. So,
maraming ganyan turo.
I'm sorry, you know, I don't mean to offend anyone. But the religious Pharisees, modern day, they love using the Greek and the Hebrew. May nakita ko dyan yung mga, babasahin nila yung buong verse in Greek. Wow, lalim. Pero ba't kayo nagtatago sa word na to?
Tsaka yung every, di ba?
Wow. Lalim nun.
Lalim yun.
Every. No. Bakit nagtatago sa word na to? Bakit lahat ng Greek kayang i-memorize, lahat ng ganyan Hebrew, na ganyan, ganito pa yung basa ng Hebrew, right to left? Basang-basa nyo lahat. Pero bakit sa word na to nagtatago?
Alam ko yan bakit.
Bakit?
Hindi gumagana siya kanila. Hindi no, kasi nila tinuturo.
But
hindi
walang
gumagana.
Excuse eh. Kasi wala dapat excuse dahil parang it's the same faith.
That's right.
Isa lang eh. Naniwala ka na kay Jesus, kunin mo na lahat. Nandyan na. It's the same word, the same Jesus, the same Bible. Guys, hindi special to. This is such a simple revelation. You are healed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You are not just saved, you are made whole. You are not broken anymore. Whatever that person did to you before that was horrible, tapos na yon. Jesus has paid for it. You are not broken. You are made whole in Christ. Siya yung pumupuno sa iyong pagkukulang. Amen. You are not poor. You are not impoverished. You are prosperous.
Kaya hindi mo sinasabi kay God na made whole kayo. Sinasabihan mo sarili mo na whole ka na dahil kay Jesus Christ.
So, grabe guys, you know what? I am not against people or denominations. I love you guys. I love all of you guys, even those that throw stones at us. Yeah. I still love you.
Mahal namin kayo.
That's okay. That's okay. You know, it's okay. Kasama yan eh.
Buti na lang malaki si Brother Rod. Siya umaharang.
Makatago kami.
Siya umaharang sa lahat ng nagbabato eh.
Nee, kasama yan pare. Luke 21:12 yun eh. You will be persecuted because of me. So okay lang.
May shields of faith naman.
Oh yan. I don't mind. I don't mind. You know, so walang problema yan. I'm not against people. I'm not against denominations. Even if you throw stones at us, okay lang. I still love you. I am against the lies of the enemy.
Yes.
that are robbing people, are robbing the children of God from sozo. That is all I am standing for. I am against the enemy that steals the word, that prevents people from seeing the cross of Christ. So if you got questions, you say, oh, question ko to, bakit ganito, bakit ganyan? Ikaw muna tanungin ko, naintindihan mo ba kung ano yung sozo? Naintindihan ba kung anong, do you know what you have in Christ? Right? Because that's the foundational problem. All these other questions, if I just address the root of the issue, will be resolved. Diba? So, anyway, guys, you know, if you really are truly born again, and I believe you are, then you can understand the full meaning of the word sozo. And nothing should prevent you from receiving it and manifesting that in your life. So, you know, guys, this question remains between you and God. This is not me. I ask you one question. I want you to talk to God about this. Do you really believe that you have received sozo? Not just salvation, not just forgiveness, sozo. That's between you and God. And I'm not judging you. No one's judging you. I don't even know the answer. I can't see you right now. But that between you and Him, Lord, totoo ba talaga sozo yung tinanggap ko? Am I complete in Christ? Or do I have to work for the other parts and not the other parts? Ano ba talaga? But you see in the Bible, sozo is not just forgiveness, it's not just healing, it's bringing back the sight to the blind. It is everything that you need. You know, stop allowing Satan to steal. Hindi God allows, we allow. People are allowing Satan to steal, kill, and destroy. You know, so...
Isisi kay God. Kasi nangyayari, kayo yung pumayag. Hindi si God. Pinayagan nyo.
Sabihin ng iba, pare, hindi ko naman pinayagan. Hindi. It's not na hindi mo pinayagan. It's, you did not choose to dig deeper. Na tinanggap mo, sige.
Okay. Siya pala may God.
Yun na yun. Diba? You know, it's... I just have to share this short testimony. Alam ko medyo umano na tayo, but... Short testimony. Before, I taught on healing. And people during that service were healed. And then an older lady came up right after the service. Excuse me. I have to rebuke you. Because healing is not physical. It's only spiritual. Sabi ko, okay. So, ano yun? Ano yung nandun? No. Because we studied that. Sabi ko, okay. So, what verse do you use to support? No. We studied it and it's not for physical, it's only spiritual healing. We studied it. Sabi ko, so what does the word mean? I have to check, but the context is spiritual healing. So, wala naman personal revelation.
Ano, henyong-henyo yan.
Pero you have the audacity. I don't mind talking to people. I don't mind. You will go up to me and say, mali yung turo mo, kahit na may na-heal dun sa kabila na ilang tao. Nawala yung pain, may uminit, may ganito, na all of a sudden, nagagalaw, naaangat na yung hindi maangat. Pero hindi eh, talagang mali pa rin. And that person, I found out, has been through like 4 or 5 major operations na life-threatening. You know, see, here's the thing, guys. Brokenness is addictive. It is a disease.
Ayun nga, yung feeling nila, pag nagtitis sila, mas malalim silang Christian.
Psychological term yan eh. Masochism.
Hindi nga, actually, masakit yun, pero totoo.
More of feeling nila, gusto nila i-prove kay God. Hindi kita... I still believe in you kahit ganyan kahirap na buhay ko. Yun yung madalas ko namimit.
Ang sinabi ko dun sa taong yun, sabi ko, you know what, sister? God loves you. But I want you to listen to me. How many people have you prayed for that received healing through Jesus Christ? Hindi siya makasagot. Sabi ko, so siguro dapat makinig ka sa akin. Kasi itong... Guys, we see healing normally. It's not even, uy pare, may na-heal. It's...
Simpleng ordinary na lang.
Kasi kasama sa sozo eh.
Kasama talaga.
You know? So, it's not like we're doing just healing for the sake of healing. We give Jesus. Healing is a byproduct of an encounter with Jesus. Hindi namin habol supernatural. These things follow. We preach the word. You don't have to preach healing to get healing. If you preach, naalala ko to eh. I heard this from a preacher before. He said, if you preach healing, you get healing. If you preach the gospel, you get healing. It is the nature of the gospel. Because it's part of sozo. Guys, remember John 10:10. Jesus came that you may have life and have it abundantly. Only the thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Today, we arrest the thief. Brother, sister, you are sozo. You are healed, you are whole, you are delivered. You are, You know, say that. I want you to say that. I am sozo.
I am sozo.
I am healed. I am whole. I am made well. I am preserved. I am protected. I am prosperous. I am doing well. Amen. I am complete. I am delivered. Lord, I am everything. I'm going to end with this verse in Colossians 2, verses 9 to 10. Ooh, nice. I love this. Colossians 2, verses 9 to 10. It says, "For in him all the fullness of deity dwells in bodily form, and in him you have been made complete.
Complete.
And he is the head over all rule and authority."
Baka spiritual rin ang isip nila ito. Spiritual completion.
Antigas nung.
Parang ano ibig sabihin ng complete? Spiritual ba yan? No, pati physical.
Complete niya eh.
Hindi, spiritual lang eh.
So yung pilay na naglakad, spiritually lang siya naglakad.
Wow. Ano, imagination?
Ito yung...
Nakalutang, pare.
Hindi, pare. Yung by his stripes, we are healed.
Spiritual yun.
Hindi rin naman...
Yung, may nagsabi sa akin nun, spiritual.
Yun nga yung nire-rebuke sa akin.
Spiritual daw.
Pero yung sugat ni Jesus, spiritual ba o physical?
Yun nga eh. Wala ba nakakita ng sugat niya? Wala ba? Yung cross... Hindi, gusto ko lang malam. Wala ba? Di ba meron? Nakalagay, may dugo, di ba?
The word healed in Isaiah 53:5 is Rapha. Yes. Rapha also is Jehovah Rapha. Yeah. But it also means physician. Doctor, used 67 times as healed and as doctor in the Old Testament. In the New Testament, 1 Peter 2:24, the word is Iaomai, which means made whole. So, by his stripes, you're whole. You're not broken anymore. Brother, sister, you are saved, you're forgiven. You're healed, you are whole, you're prosperous, you are delivered. Everything you need is in Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And guess what? You have the faith to receive it. If you believe that you've been forgiven, you have the faith to believe everything else. So, you know, that's what I got for you guys. This is, guys, again, we are not against people. We're just, nakakainis lang makita, nagugutom yung kapatid mo. Tapos, alam mo yun, ito na yung sagot, guys. Tigil na natin, just drop it. Evaluate your foundations. Hindi kami nagmamarunong, wala naman tayong pakinabang. It's not like we get anything out of this, yeah. Right? It's just out of the love that we receive from Jesus. Yes.
Hindi rin tayo nagre-recruit.
Hindi.
Wala kaming church.
Hindi kami church eh.
Yeah.
We're not a church. I'm not looking for members. I don't need members. No. I'm not looking for any of that. I'm just happy freely we receive, freely we give. So ito changed our lives. And thousands of other lives are being changed. We see them. The network is growing. This is moving worldwide now. You know, and lives are changing. People are receiving this. Step in there. Step into faith. You have Jesus. You are complete in him.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise God. Praise God.
Whoever's watching right now, you're swallowing truth right now. You are claim it and you're getting healed right now in the mighty name of Jesus. There's just a surge of anointing right now in this preaching. And I really believe that the Lord is transcending time right now. As you hear this, you know, things that you're praying for, the lies that is being purged out from your heart, it's now being replaced by truth. And right now you are getting healed and you are getting whole. And whatever you're praying for, you're having this breakthrough right now. I believe so.
Amen.
Amen. So,
bago ako mag-close in prayer, meron akong magandang ipo-point out. Yung Luke 8:56, 9:56 ba? Luke 9:56.
Wala sa ibang version.
Wala sa mga ibang version yun. So, yung he did not come to destroy men's lives but to save them. Tingnan mo. So, most, maraming translation, King James. Meron. No. So anyway, ang point ko lang is, hey man, that's a pretty important verse to leave out. So check your translations, you know, go through different translations. And regardless, with or without that verse, consistent pa rin naman yung gospel. Pero, ba't mo tatanggalin yun? You know what I mean? Anyway, so brothers, sisters, let's just join our hearts in prayer. I want you to agree with me right now because I'm going to declare the word of God upon you. And I believe miracles are happening right now. As you watch this, it doesn't matter if it's live or if it's a recording or whatever. If you watch this 5 years from when this was recorded, it does not matter. Because it's the word of God that's powerful. It's not me. It's not him. It's a truth. It's the word of God. So do you agree in faith? Lahat ng sinasabi natin, it's been done 2,000 years ago. We're agreeing with the past.
Tsaka ano, kung defeated yung life mo, baka kailangan mo mag-change.
Yeah. Yeah, bago mo kami batuhin.
Buka mo muna, di ba?
You know, I remember one last guy said, you mean to tell me, kahit na galit sa akin, bro, you mean to tell me if I go down there and I pray and I say in Jesus' name they're healed, they will be healed? I'm like, yes. I'm like, you should try it. You should.
Ang yabang mo naman.
Ha?
Ang yabang mo naman.
Tsagayin mo yung sakit mo. Basta bayad na eh. Kasi, and again guys, hindi sa binayaran na ni Jesus eh. Diba? It's not like, oh, mas malakas ako kay God kasi ako sinagot ganyan. Hindi. For everyone, it's been extended. It's a receiving problem. It's not a giving problem.
Tanggapin natin, brothers and sisters, tanggapin natin. Kasi alam nyo, patawa-tawa lang kami rito, nag-enjoy kami, pero it really hurts pag nakikita namin yung
seryoso ganun. Kami sa freedom na ino-offer ng truth. Seryoso kami dun.
That's true.
Yes.
Actually, on top of this, we're just like happy-go-lucky and all of that. But deep inside us, it's
masakit.
Grieving.
Masakit.
To actually have seen people living in a defeated life because of the lies that they've been swallowing, lies that they've been being taught to them, and you know, living a defeated life is not really godly. Like, look at what we're talking about.
San tayo nang galing?
Wow.
Just look where God picked you up from, bro. Like, I knew you from before. We knew each other from before. Na sira-sira yung buhay ng ano natin.
Walak-walak, basura.
Oh, you've been through hell too, pare. Lalo na ikaw. Sino ba kami?
Sino yung parang tayo nagkakilala sa kulungan?
Hindi, kaya mas kinagamit ako, mas broken ako eh.
Nakita-kita tayo sa kulungan, pare.
Hindi naman sa ano ah. Kung pa-brokenan lang, pare.
Yeah.
Wala kayong laban sa mga testimony na to.
Kapag nakakita ka pa ng salamin na nabasag, tapos dinikdik mo pa, nilagay mo sa tela.
No, really guys, it's not about how broken you are. You know, it's not. Because we were broken too. We were. We went through that. It was really bad. And it happened because of consequences of our own actions. Yes. But at the end of the day, we have one thing in common. Jesus made us whole. Yun lang. Freely we receive. We just want to give this to you. Kung kaya niya ayusin to kami.
Tsaka, ito lang, dagdaga lang. Huwag ka pa-focus kung sino ka, anong ginawa mo. Focus ka anong ginawa ni Jesus Christ.
Amen.
It's always on the cross.
Pagbaga sa kotse, pare, kumatok na, ibinaba yung makina, in-overhaul, pare.
Brand new.
Change engine niya, bro.
Change engine. I mean, that's the power of the gospel. You know? And nobody could deny that.
Yung amin lang is, we see you guys out there. We get your messages. We get your prayer requests. Yung pinagdaanan nyo, alam namin, we know. Dumaan din kami dyan. Ito sinasabi lang namin. Kasi hindi kami nagyayabang, wala kaming ipagmamayabang. We have nothing to boast about. It's just, we found Jesus. That's the same answer for any problem that you have. Amen? So let's pray. Lord God, Father, I thank you for this time. I thank you for my brothers and sisters who are watching this. Father, it's gonna be a simple prayer. Today, we receive and we declare we have it. We have sozo. Thank you, Jesus. We are sozo. By grace, through faith, we are sozo, Lord. We are forgiven. We thank you for your forgiveness. We thank you for saving us. We thank you that because of you, we will enter the gates of heaven. We thank you, Lord, that everlasting life is something we have now through believing in Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord, that we are healed because sozo is also healed. We thank you, Lord, we are delivered, that no demon can stand and obstruct sozo. No. Not even a demon like Legion could stand. Not even Satan himself can stand against sozo. We are sozo. Father, we thank you, we are healed. We are protected. We are prosperous. We are delivered. We are no longer broken, Lord. You were broken so that we would be made whole.
Yes.
We are now whole. We are sozo. Father, we thank you that all these things we have in Christ and Christ alone. And Father, we thank you that this is the truth that sets us free. Father, we repent of those times that we have watered down sozo. We repent of those times that we have tried to separate the forgiveness from this and that and made our own doctrines. And today we realize that that is the work of the enemy, to water down the gospel. Father, today we preach the full gospel. We receive the full gospel. We are new creations in Christ. And we are complete in Him. Whatever you're lacking right now, brother, sister, I speak life upon you in Jesus' name. I speak life upon you. I speak wholeness upon you. I speak sozo upon you and your family and the work of your hands. I speak blessing over them. I speak provision over them. It is the same sozo that raises the dead, the same sozo that cleanses the lepers, the same sozo that opens blind eyes and makes the lame walk and saves the most broken, the most sinful person and takes them, rescues them from out of the pit and takes them to the feet of the Lord Jesus. It's the same sozo that we have today. Father, we agree in faith with your word. We are complete, and we lack no good thing because we trust you. So, Father, we thank you for this. We love you, Lord. We are sozo in Jesus' name. Amen.
We love you. Amen.
Amen.
We love you, brothers and sisters. God bless everyone.
Thank you for joining us, and let's continue to worship the Lord and how we end this Christian, Metanoia Christian Broadcasting Company. Is it God good? Come on, let's join us. Let's worship the Lord.
Let's soak in His presence, everyone. Sing with us, found in your hand.
Fade away every crown. Jesus.